everyone, and welcome to the video. This is my first ever YouTube video, so I greatly appreciate your support. For this video, I will be doing a three-color challenge, but with a twist. Instead of using the usual pencils or markers that you normally see in a three-color challenge, I will be using felting wool. Here it is. It's a little bit big to see, but there's a whole bunch of colors in there. I think there's about 28. I will blindly pick three colors of wool from the bag and use only those colors to create something using needle felting. So, here goes nothing. Here is the first color, I think you can see that. Second color, and here is the last color. Ah, that doesn't look too bad. I think I can make something with that. Now, for the next stage, I'll grab out my sketchbook. And sketch some ideas that I have. Grab a sharpie pencil. Okay. So, I'm planning on doing something with an armature. So, could have a head, a neck, and a body. Legs, back legs. Something that I really enjoy doing needle felting projects is making up imaginary creatures. So like fantasy things. So I probably will do something similar to that for this. Kind of maybe give it a peacock tail. And that sort of main thing. And a beak or a snout. I think I'll go with a snout. And maybe I'll give it big long ears. That looks pretty nice. Give it a bit of a frilly feathers on the back. And there we go. This is one route I could take. I could also, let me just add in an eye there. I could also do something like an owl. I do enjoy owls. I recently created one for a friend as a Christmas gift. And it did take a little bit of time, but it looked pretty good. So I could do some kind of owl type creature. Or just an owl. Sketches don't have to be too good, they're just there to show ideas. Not really feeling this yet, so what if I chose something that I haven't really done? I could make like a serpentine type creature. I did once try to make one with scales, but the tail or the body turned out being a little bit too thick, so I chose to make a different creature. More of a bird-like creature. Oh yeah, okay, I think this one might just be it. Add an eye there, maybe. And a horn. Yes, I like this. I like this. And our red. So I'm thinking the main creature could be this gray fading into this brown with some pops of reds and on the end of the tail and on the fins and the frill and maybe the eyes. Okay.
Thank you.
result in all its glory. The colors reminded me of a kelp forest, and I thought if I did a little bit of blending and mixing, I could make something that looked like it belonged in a kelp forest. And I'm quite sure that I succeeded. I'm very happy with it. And I think we have time for one more. So now that my desk space is all cleaned and organized and ready to go, let's pick our next colors. I'm just going to reach my hand back in the bag and pick out some colors. Oh, there's a needle. First color. It's the second color. And the final color. Oh, that's pretty nice. So, I think. So, I went for serpentine creature last time. Oh, I have an idea. So, we could go with a kind of. Okay, so, head shape there. There's neck, body. I'm thinking kind of sort of back leg here. I'm not super happy with those proportions. So if I go ahead there, kind of there's the chest. I'm thinking really large front legs and paws, like this, kind of. And then really fine back legs. Oh. If I make that a little lower down, yeah, it's the sort of vibe I'm going for. But eerie, creepy kind of vibe. So, really small, fine hindquarters and a really large front legs and paws. And I think maybe make the head like that. No, I'm not sure how to make the head. I think I might go reasonably small, kind of flat, with just an eye there, so like really plain. And since those horns work so well for the last one, I might add them here. I may make that even smaller again. Probably have multiple eyes. That should add to the creepy vibe. Or maybe the neck can be like long, really long. Yes. And you can have these sort of things. Yeah, I'm really feeling this. When I originally had the idea, I thought I wanted to go for more of a kind of bear or cat-like creature. But I think this will work pretty well. This might add a little bit more time to the design process, make it a little longer video, but I think I might just add in a wing. Okay, and I think most of it would be black, and browns. And the tail will have lots of pops of colour and wings. And also the tips of the legs. And like maybe like a little stripe here. And these guys. And there'll probably be some spots and stripes here too. Alright, I'm really feeling that. Okay, I'm happy with that. So, unfortunately, the second project took a lot longer than I expected. It is finished, but if I included the footage, it would unfortunately cause the video to run way too long. So, I'm going to have to make a part two. But do not worry, that will come very soon. Thanks for watching. Like and subscribe if you feel like it. And bye.